really going to warm up quite a bit, but it's been pretty interesting the way that the winter has turned out, because if you remember back in November, the Climate Prediction Center said that the warming waters over the equator were actually starting to slow, and so that put us in a neutral pattern instead of an El Nino pattern, which would have brought us a very wet winter, and instead they were predicting that the winter could actually be pretty dry. Well, we ended up being on the positive end of this, because as you saw, storm system after storm system moving out of the Pacific Northwest, dropping all the way far down to the south, tapping into that subtropical moisture, and we had plenty of rain and plenty of snow across the state. But it still really depends on where you were, because here in Phoenix, we're above normal at this point. We're about 0.3 inches or so above normal, but in Tucson, they're about 0.5 inch below normal, and then Flagstaff, when it comes to rainfall and even snowfall, they're below normal as well. So we really did kind of luck out with these last few storm systems that have moved through. So what about the next 3 months? Well, it's looking like it's probably going to be pretty dry, which is to be expected these few months here across the state. But we're also looking at very warm weather. So I think that's already proving to be true here in the next couple of days, because we are actually expecting our first 90-degree temperature of the year within the next couple of days. And we're also expecting to hit some records. So here's kind of how we're going to go. Tomorrow, we'll make it into the mid-80s above normal. We'll be approaching 90 there on Wednesday. And then by Thursday, we're expecting to set a new record of 92, breaking the old record of 91 that was set in 2007. So a very strong ridge of high pressure building in over the southwest. Here's a look at tonight. Things feel pretty good out there. 63 right now at Phoenix Sky Harbor, 50 currently in Casa Grande. We're 52 in Sedona. In the 20s right now in Flagstaff. Out to the east, we've got the 30s over Sholo. Safford is at 53, and Tucson in the 50s. Tonight, we're going to see mild weather. 50 in Casa Grande, 53 for a low here in Phoenix under clear skies. We'll be in the 60s and some 50s along the Colorado River. But tomorrow, 70s and near 60 up in the high country. Lots of sunshine across the whole state. 83 Tucson, 80 Casa Grande. Some of the warm spots will be Gila Bend, Yuma. Some of the typical spots, places like Quartzsite, getting into the mid to upper 80s. So as we approach that 90-degree mark, we'll kind of stay there for a couple of days, likely setting records on both Thursday and Friday. Then we'll get an area of low pressure that moves into the north, kind of breaks down our high pressure a little bit. So we'll see a little bit of cooling, not a ton, but we drop down to 87 as we head into Monday. Kevin?
Thanks, Caribe. Well, the Cardinals and safety Rashad Johnson agreed to a 3-year contract, keeping one of
Kevin's already writing his essay. I'm stealing this.
The greatest. That's all I'm going to write.
That's our news. Thanks for watching. Have a great night, everyone.
And welcome to EVB Live, everyone, on this Monday afternoon. You're looking at live pictures from Tempe Town Lake. If you've been looking forward to enjoying some time outside the house, this is definitely the week to do that. I'm meteorologist Caribe Devine. This week, we'll see something we haven't seen since last year. The 90s are making a comeback. I'll tell you when that will happen and how the rest of the week is shaping up. Tran?
But first,
well, what a difference a few days makes. Those photos were taken by you last Friday after the winter storm hit. This Friday, though, will be very, very much different. And we're already starting to see those change this weekend as temperatures warmed up. And today we continue to warm up, but we're right at about where we should be right now. In fact, out at Sky Harbor, average this time of year is 76. We're sitting right now at 75. The dew point's at 22, and relative humidity is at 14%. Winds are calm. Here's a look across the valley. We're in the mid-70s for Chandler, 76 right now, Ahwatukee. It is 73 in Scottsdale, in the upper 60s for Carefree, so one of the cooler spots out there. 73 right now in Anthem, 74 Peoria. Out to the Southwest Valley, we've got Goodyear. You're at 78. It is 76 right now in Buckeye and Wickenburg at 72. Here's a look around the state. We're in the 50s, so it feels pretty good up in the high country right now for Flagstaff. 63 right now, Sedona. We're at 66 in Globe, down in Tucson at 73. And of course, some of the warmer temperatures, Gila Bend and Yuma, both checking in at 81. So this week, it's really all going to be about this very strong ridge of high pressure that's building into the southwest. In fact, so strong that we are actually expecting some record temperatures by the middle and the end of this upcoming week, and our first 90-degree temperature of 2013. So here's the next few days. Tomorrow, we're looking at a high of 85. We'll get close to 90 on Wednesday, but not quite yet. And then by Thursday, we're anticipating a high of 92. And should we hit that, Tram, we'll be setting a brand new record, breaking the old one of 91 back in 2000. 2007. Back to you.
That is so wild already. Just, we're not even halfway into March. All right, Caribe, thanks. All this gorgeous weather outside is gearing up to be an even more lovely weekend. With St. Patrick's Day right around the corner, we wanted to tell you about four big things happening right here in the Valley. Megan Finnerty, our nightlife and events expert, is at a Tempe Beach Park where one of the big events is taking place. Hey, Megan.
Hey, you guys, that's right. I'm out here enjoying. It's still kind of breezy and cool. I was just cringing during that whole broadcast, Caribe. But anyway, we've got lots of fun things we want you to put on your radar for this weekend for St. Patrick's Day. And we're going to start off with the big parade in Central Phoenix. It's Saturday. It starts at 10 a.m. And it's in its 30th year with more than 100 entries. And you know you're going to see step dancers with their bouncing ringlets, bagpipers, dignitaries, class.
It was so wild, Caribe. So South by Southwest is still going on this week. The interactive ends tomorrow, but the film festival continues, and the music portion kicks off tomorrow through next Sunday. I was so blown away and overwhelmed. And when I interviewed Mike Snyder from the USA Today, the tech reporter there, he just said, you know what, you have to go in just knowing that you cannot do it all. Just accept it. Don't even try to do everything because you just won't get to it.
You won't get to it. Okay, but yeah. This was your first time in Austin.
Loved it.
So I want to know, did you wear the cowboy boots?
Absolutely. I wore my brown cowboy boots and I fit right in.
All right. Yeah.
Coming up on EVB Live, we are connecting Arizona to a Valley school using groceries to make up for budget cuts. Wait till you see how much they raised. Well, I don't know about you, Caribe, but I did not take home ec when I was in school. Did you?
I did. That's where I learned how to bake a cake.
And anything else, or did it just stop after that?
Well, have you tasted one of my cakes?
Okay, that says it all right there. Okay, well, considered old-fashioned and by some a conspiracy to keep women in the kitchen, home ec class has disappeared from a lot of schools. But with obesity on the rise, as Karen Kafa reports, the curriculum is getting a new purpose.
Well, in addition to cooking their own food, you may consider having your kids grow their own food, too. Researchers in Australia found children were more likely to try new foods if they grew them and cooked them, too. The kids tested were gardening at their school. The experts also found some lasting effects even after the gardening ended. The children were more likely to bring healthier lunches and snacks to school.
Well, eating may be the way to get your... Well, almost all of us at one time or another have nurtured a dream, something we wanted more than anything else. Well, at the age of 62, Bobby Lancaster is trying to make hers come true. She hopes to join the LPGA Tour.
And if she succeeds, it would be historic, but not for the reason that you might think. Kevin Kennedy has one woman's emotional journey to find love and the person she always wanted to be.
You know what, ladies? A lot of people are traveling this week due to spring break, as you know. So this may be traveling this week due to international rules. Well, you know what, ladies? A lot of people are traveling this week due to spring break, as you know. So this may be an intervention of sorts. SmarterTravel.com put out a top 10 list of the most annoying things travelers do. So ladies, number one, hogging the armrests. Yeah, the experts say leave the armrest for the poor person stuck in the middle seat. I hope you don't do that to poor travelers.
I don't do that, and I hate it when it's done to me.
I know. No kidding. Okay, number two, check this out. Constant comparisons to home. If you're starting every other sentence with in America or back home, you're annoying, okay? Number three, trying to beat everyone out of the plane. You know who you are, folks. You're not more important than everyone else on the plane. So sit down and wait your turn, okay? Now, Veronica and Caribe, I know you both have kids here. How do you feel about number four, which basically says not controlling your children?
I don't have that problem.
You don't?
No, my 21-month-old son sleeps like a baby on an airplane.
And she isn't lying because we actually went to lunch over the weekend with her little one.
She can tell you.
Didn't say a word. Very well behaved.
He just sat there and just...
Cruz just sat there and watched us talk.
Yeah.
Now, Nevaeh.
She's good too. She's a professional traveler. But I will say that before I had a child, I think I was one of those people that gave the evil eye to those moms that weren't controlling their kids. And now I just really can sympathize and feel for them because you feel helpless.
Right.
You just don't know what to do. You're nervous about everyone around you and you can't control your kid, which sometimes it wouldn't matter what you did. They wouldn't respond. So I do feel for them now. now. I'm a little bit more compassionate. Right. I even try to help.
All the parents are envious of the both of you.
Yeah, okay. Probably.
Well, number five is actually the flight attendant's pick for most annoying, and that's snapping your fingers to get their attention. It is so rude, you guys. Just ring the call bell if you really need something. So the list goes on and on. I can say that annoys me.
I can't believe people.
That's just wrong.
It's just disrespectful. As our floor director snaps at us. Yeah. Okay. Keep on talking. On our EVB Live Facebook page, we asked what annoys you most while traveling. I wonder if snoring is going to be on that list. That annoys me too. To list your complaints or to look at the rest of the top 10 lists, just go to our EVB Live Facebook page. We've posted it all there for you. Well, ladies, we all know there is nothing cuter than babies, especially your babies. Mm-hmm. And these babies are also quite adorable. Volunteer firefighter Brandon Poole and his family were driving down a South Carolina road when they saw what they thought were puppies in a box, right? Well, they were squeezing.